Perfect Match is brought to you by the good time and great taste of McDonald's Family Restaurants.
Hello, I'm Brian Smith and I'd like to run the transport system.
Hi, I'm Mark Dimmick and I want to meet a lady with loads of personality.
And I'm Sam Baden and I want to rule the world and make it better.
Well, the first three contestants on Perfect Match. And who's the star of the show?
Thank you very much, everybody. Thanks for this in the studio. There they are, smiling faces. Thank you too at home around the country. Hope you got a good weekend coming up. And to Brian, Mark and Wissam, nice to have you on the show. Please take a seat. It's going to be fun tonight. Here's Kerry Friend.
It is going to be fun tonight. Hello. Hello, everyone. How are you?
Oh, your nail just went into my little hand.
Oh, no.
Did too.
Poor thing.
Okay, and to everybody in Adelaide tonight, all enjoying the Grand Prix.
Absolutely, and hey, Melbourne this weekend starts...
My quick impersonation of the Grand Prix. Who won? Okay, Kerry, tell us about our first lady, please.
All right, I will, Greg. Our first single enjoys a date with a romantic twist. Please welcome Rachel McEwen.
Hello, Rachel! Wacko! Tall lady, Rachel.
Yeah, very tall. Yeah.
So I guess you're looking for a tall man, Rachel.
Yes, hopefully over 6 foot.
Kerry said you wanted a date with a man with a romantic twist.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind a date and then somebody whisk me off to Paris.
Oh, just take it as it comes in the end, eh?
Yeah.
Now, a gym instructor you are?
Yeah, I work at a gym.
Guess you spend a lot of time working out, huh?
Yeah, a couple of hours.
Big workout in the morning and then lots of baby powder.
Yes.
Okay, and do you want to play netball for Australia?
I would like to eventually.
Good on you. Rachel, take a seat.
Thanks.
And all the very best of luck to you tonight. Rachel, on the other side of the screen, three blokes. According to statistics, one of them is your perfect match, Rachel, and it is your job to try and pick him by asking the questions that you have prepared. First question, please, to number one.
Okay, contestant number one. What has been the most memorable thing you've done to please a woman?
Teaching her how to trust a man again.
Right, because she was heartbroken prior to having you.
Giving her help.
Number two.
When I bought a 18-karat gold bracelet.
Yep, and number three, what's been the most memorable thing you've done to please a woman?
I've took her for a ride and let her forget all her troubles and worries behind.
Where did you took her for a ride?
To somewhere special.
To somewhere special. In your car?
Yeah.
Yep. Rachel?
Taking on a ride, actually.
Yeah, good stuff.
Number three.
First match goes to number three. Be a good fun going for a ride, someone special. Rachel, next question, please, to contestant number two.
Okay. If you had the choice, which two people would you like to have been...
If you had the choice, which two people would you like to
have... been your parents.
Your parents, righto.
No one except your mum and dad, because they're always there when I want them.
Yep, wouldn't change them for the world. Number three?
If they weren't my own parents, I would like to choose Lady Diane and Prince Charles.
Yeah, they'd be very handy. And then you'd be a little prince, wouldn't you?
Yeah, why not?
Number one.
Groucho Marx and Mae West.
Rachel.
Right, I think my own mum and dad, number two.
Yeah, number two's got himself on the match. And your next question, please, to number three, Rachel.
Okay, what's the most unusual thing you're likely to be remembered for?
The things that we usually do in school, like jokes, playing around. The happy things, of course.
The happy things that you used to do at school, like playing around. Yeah. Mm. Number one.
My bad habit of making terrible puns, Greg. It's really bad, you know. I'm a pretty punny person.
No pun achieved. Number two.
Have to be my two pet monkeys. I've got Charlie and Susie.
You've got two pet monkeys?
Yeah. Yep. Rhesus monkeys. Yep.
Grease monkeys?
What? Rhesus.
Oh, I'm sorry. Rachel.
Probably number two.
Oh, well, that's okay. Whatever you reckon, Rachel, here. Yeah. Rachel, full of enthusiasm here, has had two matches with number two and a match with number three. 10 seconds for you now, Rachel.
Oh.
Rachel, what's going through your head?
The odds. The best thing. I think contestant number two.
Number two is Rachel. Contestant number one, Rachel, is a station assistant who loves travelling. His name's Brian Smith. Well, go. Good on you, Brian. Contestant number three is a student who likes taekwondo. Wissam Bardan. Thank you, Wissam. And number two's got the date. He's a fitter and turner, and his hobbies include four-wheel driving and water skiing. Rachel McEwen, please meet Mark Dimnick.
Hello.
Thea, Rachel, you've got your tall, spunky man that you were looking for, and this weekend you're off to the Whit Sunday.
You'll love it. Oh, my word, you will, Rachel and Mark. You'll experience a unique slice of paradise at Contiki Whitsunday Resort. Spend sun-drenched days working on a tan, or for the energetic, there's water skiing and parasailing among a multitude of activities. Dive in the reef, or dive in the pool, or perhaps dive in the smorgasbord. It's a fun-packed tropical delight. Compliments of Contiki Whitsunday Resort and Perfect Match.
Well done, Rachel. You have chosen Mark. Mark's very happy about that. And there you go, you're off to the Whitsundays. Now, if you're the perfect match, you'll be going with these prizes.
Now, Rachel, you'll receive two stunning jumpers crafted from lamb's wool and angora. These feature delightful designs, highlighted with sequins and beading, with the compliments of Echo. And for you, Mark, you'll receive the superb package of men's French leather goods. And they include billfold, wallet, belt and key case, compliments of Lavant Leather Goods.
Lovely, wonderful stuff. Happy about that?
Yeah, it's good.
Right, you got it. You must have chosen your perfect match to win those. And to find out, here's Dexter.
I go to pieces, but I'm through to bits, Rachel. Your perfect match with a compatibility score of 74% is Mark Dimnick.
Rachel's got her perfect match. She's up to the Whitsundays this weekend, and Mark's wrapped. Great stuff, Mark. Congratulations to you. We're going to take a break after all this excitement. We will be back in just a moment with a couple who separated a lot once they hit Hawaii. Everybody, welcome back to Perfect Match. As we take a look now at the time, electrical linesman David Bull appeared on our show. David had the choice of Maria, Julie or Linda and chose contestant number one trainee manager Maria Bibas. Here they are when they first met on the show. Let's take a look at what happened when David first set eyes on Maria. We sent them off to beautiful Hawaii for their first date, where first they took a look at these parrots. Have a look at these. Aren't they gorgeous? Look at that blue one on the right. And of course, the one that David's holding matches his shirt almost. Then it was down to the beach for a little bit of snorkeling. Not a good look, David. Not a good look. But in Hawaii, be nice. Unfortunately, though, David looks like as if he's got the wrong skin for it. And there's Maria helping him with some suntan lotion. Not sure. Oh, they're in a limousine here. Yes, seeing the sights around town in a limousine and then meeting some of the locals. They look pretty well dressed up too, don't they? Colourful Hawaii. Before they came home, time to clown around just a little bit as well. Let's bring them back and find out the Maria and David story. Maria and David.
Great, how's it going?
Whoa. Okay, how was Hawaii?
Wonderful. Wonderful.
How did you go, David, with your fair skin in Hawaii?
Oh, great. Hawaii. All the beaches. Everyone was black and brown. Look at me, I was white. Unbelievable. Clearly you can cover your faces, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You didn't get burned or anything?
Oh, mate, did I get burned?
Badly, yeah. Huh?
Not really badly. Maria,
you were there. You were there to rub the lotion on him. Did you get to know David well during the weekend, Maria?
Oh, well enough, I think.
Well enough. What does that mean? We'll take a look at what they said when they returned from their date. We started by asking David what he thought of Maria's personality.
Her personality, very different to mine. Yeah, we were sort of like two opposites.
I think we both agreed that we didn't really have much in common.
Main differences are, I think I like to be a little bit more outgoing and do things. I think Maria likes to do her own thing. She's an individual.
We had a little trouble conversing, just, you know, talking about any subjects, because we have a different outlook on life altogether.
Well, was there any romance?
No romance, none at all.
I knew David and I weren't right romantically, right from the beginning.
I knew romance wasn't going to work when we first talked on the plane.
I can't imagine Who would suit David? I don't know. Possibly a traditional sort of girl who likes the man to be the boss and who likes to... maybe someone who'd be happy to settle down and have children and be a housewife.
Finally, how does David see the future with Maria?
Anything for the future? Oh, I don't think so. I think friendship. Yeah, for sure. I'm sure there's a friendship there.
I don't think there's any future for us because we don't share the same interests.
The sort of lady I would have liked to have met would have been somebody who is very outgoing, romantic. I mean, the setting was romantic. Someone I could just enjoy the whole weekend with.
It didn't disappoint me that I didn't go away with my perfect match because I usually travel alone and I like it that way because I just go wherever I feel and meet a lot more people.
Well, Maria, why do you think you and David aren't suited?
It takes all kinds of people to make a world, Greg, and not everyone's the same, and thank God we're not.
Not even as friends.
Oh, we're...
David, are you disappointed at the outcome of this date?
Oh, not disappointed, Greg. I mean, as Maria said, we are different, but it would have been nice. It was a very romantic setting, and it would have been nice to share and sort of done some outrageous things, because I like doing outrageous things. So.
As they say in the classics, better luck next time.
Yeah.
Here's a gift for you both for coming back.
Great.
Yes, Maria and David, there's exciting viewing ahead with this great package of new release videos, including Jilted, Drowning by Numbers, Spirits, and the great Australian production Waterfront. Top entertainment compliments of video, Easy and Perfect Match.
Great movies. Have a look at them on a romantic night that you're having some. Okay, well, look, thanks for coming back and telling us the story. I'm glad you both at least enjoyed Hawaii, even if there's not going to be a future, a romantic future.
Thanks.
Righto. We'll take a break. The very last of Perfect Match Personal, straight after these messages.
Unmatch contestants will receive the new electronic Perfect Match board game from J&H Toys. Plus, tonight's Unmatch guys will enjoy fabulous blockbuster movie attractions, be entertained as guests of whites, while the girls will enjoy great food and a fun show at the Crazy House Theatre Restaurant. Plus, for all contestants, delicious assorted chocolates of excellence from Daryl Lee.
Thank you very much, everybody. We're on a special occasion this one as we conclude Perfect Match Personal with a wrap-up of the week. And it's been a nice one, hasn't it?
It's been fun, and we've had lots of success out of Personals too, I might add.
So let's take a look now at who we met this week.
Okay. Well, on Monday we started off with Phil, a nurse from Strathpine in Queensland.
Hi, I'm Phil. I'm looking for a mature, intelligent woman who might like to play a round or two. Oh, golf.
And this is Alon. We met him on Tuesday night. He's a sales assistant from Bondi in New South Wales.
I like tennis, cycling, canoeing, horse riding, most sports in the outdoors. I want to get ahead in life, but money doesn't mean everything to me.
On Wednesday, we met Carmel, a pensioner from Beenleigh in Queensland.
I like crocheting, gardening, cooking, meeting people, going out for drives. Dining out, I also like country and western music.
And last night it was Dave, a clerk from St Ives in New South Wales.
I play competition timpin bowling. I'm also a member of the Army Reserves in my spare time. I enjoy travelling, going out and having a good time.
We've met some great people, as you can see, and if you'd like to meet any of them, this is all you have to do.
Write a full letter of introduction, but make it quick, including a photograph of yourself to Phil of Strathpine, Alon of Bondi, Carmel of Beenleigh, or Dave of St Ives. Post Office Box 732, Richmond, Victoria, 3121.
Thank you, Bruce. Of course, we can't guarantee success, but we will pass on all suitable replies and hope that those people can achieve the success as others have done
yes.
on Perfect Match Personal.
Good luck
thank
to them
you
all, too.
To all those people who participated in it over the last year.
Yes.
And congratulations to those who have achieved success. By the way, I hope everybody going to the Derby in Melbourne tomorrow achieves success.
That's
are you going to have
right.
a little flutter?
I'm going to have a bit of a bet.
Beginning of spring
carnival. Yes, getting ready for Melbourne Cup next week.
In the meantime, Kerry, we have three lucky last ladies to meet this Friday night.
We do indeed. Our first contestant wants to hold a formal dinner party on a raft. Please welcome Melanie Milne. Our next contestant would like to ride a camel in Arabia. A big welcome tonight to Alison Radford. And our last contestant for this week wants to be a famous character actor. Say hi to Simone Wilson.
Carlos always looks so beautiful at Flemington for the Derby.
They do indeed.
It's wonderful.
Have a good weekend.
Yeah, you too. Okay, good luck in Adelaide on Sunday. Please take a seat, ladies, and welcome to our show. Well, maybe we should talk more with number one. Oh, you're right. She's up there. They're big, tall chairs. Tell us a bit more about your life.
A bit more? I love travelling, and I've just come back from far north of Australia.
Good on you. Number two?
I'm an optical technician and I enjoy cake decorating.
So what, do you make glasses, do you, or what?
Yes, that's correct.
And so in your spare time you like to make cakes?
Cakes and decorations, yeah.
Mm. And number three?
I'm a student and I like painting people.
Painting people?
Painting portraits of people.
Yeah. Fine, I understand. Big hand for these three ladies. Bruce, tell us all about their name, please.
Certainly, Greg. I think Single would one day like to become a flying instructor. Welcome, Roderick Carmichael.
All right, Roderick.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, that's going right.
Now, Rod, tell us about yourself. You've got a strange ambition in life.
Well, yes, Greg. It's certainly a bit strange from the point of view of the public, I'm sure, but from my point of view, I'm trying to get something to promote, to sort of recapture the atmosphere and the glory that was the Phillip Island Grand Prix last year. I think that trailer backing would be certainly one
trailer aspect. Backing?
I like racing trailers while I'm backing them, yeah, certainly.
Oh, so you've got a race full, while you're right, backing full, trailers?
Heyman Reeves kid on the back.
How, what speeds long, would you get up to?
60, 70.
And then one little slip, and that's
it's all over, fella. Like, you've been on the tip before, haven't you? You go to the tip and you try and back into the tip.
Yeah, I know, it's pretty hard, isn't it? Pretty hard. Yeah. Okay, well, look, good luck to you with that ambition, and take a seat now, please, Rod.
No worries,
all the very, very best of luck to you tonight, too. Maybe these ladies would be into trailer backing
as
well.
Yeah, I'm sure they might be, too.
Rod, please ask your first question to contestant number one.
Right, contestant number one, what is the most embarrassing comment your father's ever said about you whilst you've had a boyfriend about?
Don't go trailer backing with him, dear.
Besides that, he said, take care of my little girl, she's the only one I have.
Yes, typical father statement, isn't it? Number two?
My father said he really likes big families.
My goodness. Number three, what is the most embarrassing comment your father ever made in front of your boyfriend?
When I first met, he said, hi son, how are you?
Oh. Rod.
Well, I think the big families caper sounds pretty good to me, actually, because a lot of fun. I mean, we have a bit of fun out there.
Fair enough. Number two's got the first match with Rod. As you ask your next question to number two, please, Rod.
Right, number two. If you were to have two of your possessions placed in a museum which would represent you, what would they be?
They'd be my French perfume collection and my blue fun-top car.
What sort of a car's your blue fun-top car?
It's a Mazda 121. Oh. It's got a fun-top that goes right back.
Oh, that's good. And your perfume collection. Number three.
That'd be my long black gloves and a Kraft cheese slice.
A Kraft cheese slice?
Yeah.
In a time capsule?
Mm. In a museum.
Oh, in a museum, I beg your pardon. Number one.
My lingerie and my teddy bear.
Rod.
Well, that's certainly a hard one. I would like to say, probably lingerie, yeah, why not?
None of us thought it was that hard, Rod. Last question to number three, please.
Okie coke, number three, which of your features do you want to hand on to your children? Don't want them to inherit?
My chubby cheeks.
You don't want yes, number...
Chubby cheeks.
She said chubby cheeks.
Which one?
Number one. Which features do you hope that your children don't inherit?
My bust.
Her
it's
bust.
Unnoticeable at the moment.
Pardon? Number two.
My loud laugh.
Rod.
Number one, thanks.
Number one, thanks. Two matches to number one has Rod had, and one match to number two. Here's your 10 seconds, Rod. Righto, Rod, the trailer backer, what are you thinking?
Well, one is the word that I want to always try and encapsulate in anything that I do, and I'd like to do it tonight, to tell you the truth. Number one.
Number one's got a date. Rod, let me introduce you to contestant number two. This lady is an optical technician who enjoys floral cake decorating, Alison Radford. Number three is a student who likes painting. Please meet Melanie Milne. And number one is the lady you've chosen, and you will try and encapsulate number one into your night tonight. This lady is a waitress, and her interests include horse riding. She likes water skiing, and she likes drawing. I think you'll like her a lot. Rod Carmichael, please meet Simone Wilson. Simone,
Simone, this guy is crazy and you'll love him to death. And this weekend you're both off to Byron Bay.
They look fabulous, Roderick and Simone, don't they? At beautiful Byron Bay Beach Resort, you'll enjoy a relaxed back-to-nature environment. Your individual chalets are set on spacious park and woodland, fronting up to kilometres of stunning beachfront. You could try a hit of golf or tennis, play in the pool, or go horse riding along deserted sandy beaches. Then dine in style at the intimate beachside restaurant. You'll experience the lifestyle of the rich and famous on this wonderful weekend. Compliments of Byron Bay Beach Resort and Perfect Match.
Okay, Rod, you went with the odds. Two matches with Simone. What are your thoughts initially?
Initially, what's that mean?
Now.
Oh, yeah, okay. Great.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Well, okay. Well, no, let's take a break, and then we'll return and find out, Rod, if you've chosen your perfect match in Simone. Now with Rod and Simone, and you're off to Byron Bay for the weekend. If you're the perfect match, you'll take these prizes.
Rod and Simone, if you're the perfect match, you'll be really cooking because you'll both receive a deluxe microwave oven. This top-of-the-range oven features electronic touch controls, automatic time and temperature, cooking as well as auto-start function and auto-weight defrost. There's some great meals ahead, compliments of Samsung and perfect match.
Well done, Rod, and all the very best to you if you win that prize. To find out if Simone's your perfect match, here's Dexter.
Thank you, Greg. Rod, I'm pretty excited. Your perfect match with a compatibility score of 71% is Melanie
was the perfect match. Sorry about that, folks. We must fly. Good night, Kerry and Dexter.
Good night, Kerry.
Good night, everyone. Enjoy your weekend. See you soon. Bye.
Have a safe weekend, and we'll see you on Monday night. Good night now. Bye.
This is a Grundy television production in association with 10 TV Australia. Bruce Mansfield speaking.